Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the final episode of The Wolf Among Us from Telltale Games, the ongoing murder mystery set in the world of fables of graphic novel fame. So this may be the end of the story of The Wolf Among Us, but it is only the beginning of the story of fables. There are no less than 22 volumes of the original comic book series. Ran for 150 issues originally, and they're all available in trade paperbacks. And then there's a whole bunch of one-shots. There's Jack of Fables, which is a spin-off series. There's other mini-series. There's a comic book adaptation of this, and there's a new Fables series starting up with a new creative team apparently as well. So lots and lots of stuff. So if you like what you see, you can read till your eyeballs fall out, and you'll get lots more stories. So, in the meantime, let's finish this one, shall we? I don't know about you, I'm dying to know how it ends. I'm just trying to switch inputs, and my remote is not responding. Hold on, There we go, okay. So I just gotta switch over to the other thingy. Oh, there you go. Skinslip says, Ever After is the name of the new series. The original series does have, like, a proper ending to it, apparently, so, you know, you won't necessarily be left hanging. But if you want more, there's more coming after that. All right, here we go. Episode 5, Cry Wolf. All right. I'm guessing Bigby's gonna wolf out something fierce in this one, judging from all the, episode posters and stuff.
I mean, your eyes and the teeth. You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Not if I can avoid it.
Bye, Faith. R.I.P.
No.
Holly's sister, Lily.
I just don't know what Bigby's doing. If he cares about it. If he even gives a shit.
That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
We're destroying the tree. No!
We're not burning the tree, Snow.
Well, it's like we're seeing almost all our choices.
Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
Wow.
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you.
Boy, this is gonna be our comeuppance for everything we've done in the entire game so far.
This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
Don't even get an intro, just a recap.
Thank you.
just like to say I had that theme song running through my head all day today.
You've come a long way. You must be tired.
Dramatic smoking.
And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently. Please, Sheriff, relax for a moment, will you? Do you want a drink? Something to eat? Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin. Well, Gramercy me. Take a seat at the very least.
I'm here for one reason, and it's not to eat your fucking food.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey. Well, Sheriff, for the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You know why I'm here. You killed those women.
What women?
Faith and Lily, the girls who worked at the Pudding and Pie.
Did I now? I assume by your confidence in accusing me, you must have some proof of this, yes? Some allotment of evidence. A witness, perhaps. Hmm?
Your servant over there told me you did it.
That's a fucking lie! I didn't say anything like
it's
that.
Fine.
All I said was that this was your town, and nothing wouldn't happen without your approval. All right? That's it.
If only that were true. Those women. I don't relish telling you that the killings were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with. You really don't need to worry yourself further.
An unfortunate bit of business? You're gonna tell me right now who killed him.
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information. You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation? The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hit and get out?
Tweedledee, please.
I'm already pissed off. You don't want to make it worse.
You think I'm scared of you? You're nothing more
That's
than a...
That's enough! I was hoping it wouldn't come to this. But in the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie.
Actually, surprised
However,
he told
me. Like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie.
You got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down. Now.
Yeah, I killed him, so what? You should have just kept your nose where it fucking belonged.
Georgie.
Why'd you do it? Why kill them?
Does it matter?
Look, the fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. But you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then
you
attempt
told me
to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis. You're just gonna let him do this?
Yes. Yes, they
so
are.
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
What the hell?
Take this fucker.
Take all of them. I didn't fucking
Don't
start
make
this.
Don't make any trouble, Georgie.
Are you seriously throwing me under the fucking carriage after everything I've done for you?
No deals. It's over, so get up.
I'd advise against that approach, Bigby.
You can't just hand me over! What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like that?
You think I give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers
just
are?
Just get the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying?
Yeah, what the fuck? You're gonna make sure we all go down this shitter with you?
I told you!
Get the fuck away from me! He's the one you fucking want!
This could have gone so well. But you just had to complicate things. To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
What? Oh, shit. Oh, fuck.
Did I miss anything good?
Oh, God.
Well, look at you all fixed up.
Oh, shit. Oh, great. Great, I get to fight the whole room of them.
Take this!
You're done, Wolf!
Come on, we're pretty much done here.
I'd like to say it was nice knowing you, but I'll be glad to see your insides turned out.
Oh, shit. Damn it.
This way.
Could have gone worse. Could have gone better too, but it could have gone worse. Great Red Shark says, "May I say thank you to Zeren Isaac for giving me reason to read these comics. You're very welcome. You've given me reason too, actually. I'm dying to check them out now." Oh shit! Oh, Oh, come on, I totally pressed it. Yes.
What was that?
Bigby, get up! Get up! Go!
Gun it!
Are you sure?
Do it!
He's not moving.
Keep going!
Up his freaking ass. He says, holy shit, you could have gotten Crooked Man instead. Wow. That choice was not obvious when you jumped from the bridge, so I suppose it's there so you can get a better ending the second go. I don't know. Maybe. I didn't even notice that either until, like, I had already made the decision.
Come on. We can't stay here.
Hang on. I need a minute.
Okay. How did this happen, Georgie? Can you stand up? It's okay. Take your time. Slowly.
Oh, it's no fucking use. No way I'm walking out of here. Well, it won't be your fault. It'll all land on me in the end. Oh, fuck.
Here. It's gonna be...
Shit. Mm-hmm. Hello, Bigby. I hoped you'd come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go. That it, Sheriff? I had to say goodbyes first.
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
Vivian, you don't know what you're doing.
I'm trying to help you here.
You can't seriously want to protect this guy. You know what he did.
I'm not going anywhere. It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then?
I
you fucking... You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to! You can't fucking blame me for that.
Look, I'm
Sometimes you just have to do what you're told. Then it comes back to bite you in the ass because some good-for-nothing crooked bastard... Decide you're not worth shit anymore.
Why'd you do it then, huh? If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the Crooked Man wasn't too thrilled.
But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Cause it's not my fault. The Crooked Man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out. The both of you can go rot in hell.
Georgie.
You think I'm the one to fucking blame?
That's not what I meant. I was just trying
to... I know what you were trying to do. You think that'll help? You still haven't learned, have you? Still the same old fucking moron. Go ahead and kill me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault. But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know? At the end of the day, you're just like him. Coming here, talking about options. Like it was that simple.
You could have done anything else. You could have let them go. You could have freed Faith and Lily from those fucking ribbons instead of murdering them.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them... what would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die... do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you doing?
I told you, you don't know the fuck about anything.
What are you talking about?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off, couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
Oh, shit.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers. The spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
I know that. But did it have to be like this?
How could you do this? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand. Nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started, anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were gonna be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the Crooked Man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell. Save the fucking day.
Stop it.
I told you. Sometimes all your options are shit. What the fuck are you supposed to do then?
I'm not playing this game, Georgie. I won't kill her.
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
I wasn't really...
Just shut up.
You're right. It's your life.
I know what I've done.
Wait.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily, to all of them.
Vivian, wait, I...
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them, what I took away from them. I look at Narissa and I hate myself.
Vivian!
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian, don't!
Oh, no.
Vivian, Georgie. No!
Oh my God!
No, 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 no! Why'd you have to do that, Vivian?
Oh my God.
Vivian! Shit!
Damn it!
D-
That is
Vivian,
so tragic.
I didn't fucking mean it. I was just... Oh!
Get up. Get up!
Don't think so, Bigby.
Jesus.
I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the Crooked Man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right? For both of us. You know the bastard deserves it.
He's gonna have it worse. Don't worry.
George, you'll remember that for the 30 seconds he has
old
left to live.
Old foundry by the river. All right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one. That's what you want to do, right? Well, whatever it is, just get it over with. I'm not sticking around for much longer.
That's not who I am.
Sure it's not. No more games, all right? We both know how this ends. Just make it quick. I know what I did. Let's not draw this out.
Georgie.
Damn. That ended tragically. So far, this has been the all Bigby show. There's been like nothing with any of the other characters. Yeah, we'll just take a little look around before we go kicking the door in.
Still warm. He's here, all right.
He didn't miss very much, Jail. He missed maybe 15 minutes. Jail was just wondering what time we started. He came a little bit late.
So this is where they've been sending these.
Well, I like the shadow there, how it changes the... See that? makes it white when the shadow's on it, and then it's dark when... That's really clever. I like that. Little subtle graphical touches, you know, I like stuff like that.
Wolf.
Oh god. Where is
the
she?
The big bad wolf.
Well, you know there's gonna be something with Mary. Dracula, maybe?
You used to be something.
Oh my god. He's been watching us. Damn. That's not good.
They used to fear you. They'd hide anywhere their small shivering bodies.
Holy shit, why you gotta be so creepy? Of course, you are Bloody Mary.
It's about time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way, now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Wow, what a man. Stealing punches while my back is turned. Didn't your mother ever teach you to fight proper?
Damn it. Damn her teleporting. Oh shit. See, what I'm wondering is that just Mary's glamored form? Does she have a scarier form? Head up there. Okay. Skins that raises a valid point, he says, but Mary, you sucker punched Bigby in the last scene you were with him. That is true. Oh, we gotta go. Damn, okay. Oh, shit! Damn it. That was a little too fast for me to react.
Ugh!
are you? Come out and face me!
Oh, shit. Oh, God, I knew it. Holy crap. Oh, broken mirror shards. And... oh, my God. Everywhere. Holy crap. Oh my gosh. Wow. Bigby is not messing around. Damn it. Doing. Yep. That's great. That was awesome. Thanks for the donation. So Sorry, I don't get the alerts on my screen here, so sometimes I miss them. So thank you for those of you in the chat mentioning when there is stuff. Definitely appreciate it. Uh-oh. Crooked Man should be shitting his pants right now. Earned a trophy.
Hello,
a
Bigby.
Bullet.
You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds 6 rounds of specially designed silver bullet. I won't miss next time. Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want. You plan to do what she says, don't you?
Snow's not here. You're dealing with me now.
That may be true, but I'd advise against defying your new boss, at least for the time being. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial. Are we clear?
You need to tell me right now. We're not going anywhere until I get some answers from you.
If you want answers, you're going to have to cooperate with me. Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
Maybe you didn't carry it out, but I don't think Georgie was lying when he said you ordered their deaths.
Georgie would have said anything to save himself. We both know that. I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers, but you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth? Or do you just want to look like the hero? Because those are two very different things.
This is about justice. I'm the sheriff. I have to do what's right. 2 people were murdered.
And you know who did it. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in, but you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle. You know, I'm actually looking forward to seeing Miss White again. My previous interactions with her have gone rather well.
All right, let's go. Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind. What do you say?
Hey!
I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
Yeah.
You're under arrest. Given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
Yeah. I made a promise to Snow. There was enough killing today. Oh, that's a great red shark says, I do believe there is an achievement for never missing a button prompt ever in the game. I'm sure there is. That'd be great. You earned a trophy. My last cigarette.
I know. But we have to do something.
Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to... He's back.
The Crooked Man.
Thank God.
Motherfucker.
Are you okay? It's been hours. We were worried you'd run into some trouble. At the Crooked Man's place. And after what happened with Mary...
Well, he didn't make it easy.
What happened?
It doesn't matter. He's here. We got him.
We can talk about it later. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just
I didn't rip his lungs out and feed them to him.
Peace.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting for?
You killed Lily!
She was my sister!
How could you?
What do you have to say for yourself?
Where the fuck do you get off? You think you have the right to just do this to people? You're a fucking crook!
This? You should be ashamed.
Shithole.
Everyone?
Remember,
Crooked
Man.
Can I have your attention?
This is what you wanted.
Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder
As
of
I
Faith
already
and...
informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Porgy who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie? Georgie?
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White, but I thought it would be unwise to proceed with such faulty information.
Bigby, is that true?
Georgie may have killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yeah, Sheriff. Where is that rotten scoundrel now?
Damn it.
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Well, where is he?
Sheriff?
I killed him. He's dead.
He's what?
Dead. So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no
that doesn't change anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And
I was told I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you'd wait a moment.
I'm well aware of my rights, Miss White. Unless you plan to abandon the charter entirely.
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
Yeah.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolf.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I had nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Bullshit! Like hell you didn't.
Stop the charade. We know you're involved.
Come on, it's obvious.
And there's all the other crap he's done.
Everyone just shut up for a minute. You wanted a chance to talk, well go ahead.
What?
We all know he's guilty. What the fuck does he need to speak for?
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government, and most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death. Upon which, your body will be committed to the witching
Where world. It fucking belongs!
That's
so
right.
Let's get on
but
with
we
it
promised
then.
You a chance to defend yourself. And I won't rob you of that right.
What the
You're
fuck?
Really going
this
to let
is
him
about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
This is ridiculous.
Well, I wouldn't have taken the cuffs off.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh, jeez.
Are you going to get to your point or what?
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees. I had nothing to do with it.
This is such bullshit!
He's always been a bit of a powder keg. It was only a matter of time before something like this happened.
Georgie seemed pretty convinced he didn't have a say in the matter.
He clearly misunderstood my intention.
Really?
I would never authorize such an act.
Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
What's he talking about?
You weren't being helpful. You were trying to set me up. Your people tried to kill me.
They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I protected them. You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
What's he talking about?
Yeah, right. They don't do it because they want to protect you. You intimidate people. Use scare tactics. They're afraid if they don't follow orders, they'll end up dead.
Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that. Hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
What about Lily? She wasn't free. She wasn't given a choice. Do you really think she wanted... that any of those girls wanted their lives like that?
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry that your sister asked me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my better judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us. How you kept us all
in
line.
You forget it was not me who put you in that position. You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant. When your government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
Wasn't I?
You're the fucking problem here, not us.
Really? What about Archie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
She wanted my tree destroyed, but Bigby refused.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you want that?
Is that true? Don't blame Snow, she had her reasons. Greenleaf was using her magic to help Crane and the Crooked Man. That's why Snow wanted your tree burned.
That's not why.
It wasn't her fault.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with a Crooked Man.
We've made some mistakes. I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town. And that may not always be clear right away, but I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can. But I can promise to always have your best interests at heart.
Like you did with her?
Maybe you haven't noticed, but we've been doing all this to protect you. We're trying to stop people like him.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you. Exploiting your hope for a better life. You would go to him for help. And he would take that weakness and add it to his strength. And if things didn't fall exactly his way, someone would die.
Do you really think the Crooked Man cared about you? He just cared about your money. He cares about your obedience.
They're right.
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over. And those girls will have their justice.
Damn. I think that went rather well.
Very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the murders.
Georgie was working for you. Bigby got a confession.
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's history.
What are you talking about?
Snow?
And what about your history? All you've done to this fucking town?
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just
Of mean... course it's right! This man tormented all of you, for profit! Georgie
Let
killed
him... Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course!
Where are you going with this?
If I'm to blame for Georgie's mistakes, shouldn't Miss White be held accountable for Bigby's actions as well?
Like what?
How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right.
Did you think we'd all just let that go?
You can't be serious.
Snow had nothing to do with it. We all thought she was dead.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened.
Yeah.
Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
Wow.
That's enough.
So, ouch. You won't answer for your employees' behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
This is completely different.
Did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
this
crimes.
This isn't right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you.
Listen, I know...
The laws apply when we need them
Bluebeard,
to.
Bluebeard, please.
That's not true.
I mean, a certain level of privilege should be afforded to...
To who?
This is how it's always been.
Yes. See, this is exactly to what I'm speaking. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be
the- Bigby? Miss White!
What?
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath?
What's she doing here?
I'd like to- I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Bluebeard.
What?
Of course. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't...
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. Hey. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Be quiet.
We need to establish some order here.
Vivian wanted you freed from the ribbons. She took her own life.
I'm sorry, I don't think I
know you. Nerissa! My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me. And now I can finally say, You're an asshole. And I hope you rot at the bottom of the witching well for what you did.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty.
Good enough for me.
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves.
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
Wait!
What?
What did you expect to happen here? You're getting what you deserve.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever, somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's not good enough.
Maybe
there will be more if he isn't stopped.
Been enough bloodshed.
So we get rid of him.
It's too dangerous.
We can send him everyone, away. Listen up! Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment. So I think
this is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
Why not?
What about a vote?
What do you think this is?
Everyone, calm down.
Look, Snow should decide what we do with him. She's gonna be the deputy mayor, so...
But she's not the deputy mayor yet.
What about Bigby? What about him? He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine. Are you sure? This isn't how
it's... It's what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Snow.
Just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff.
Lock him up. Rip his head off.
Teach him a fucking lesson.
Throw him down the
well. He has to die.
We can lock him
away. Just fucking get rid of him.
Not this way.
Damn it. I was just about to make my decision. Oh, no, you don't.
There you are. I hope you all remember this moment.
Think of me when you try to sleep. Finish it, Sheriff.
Please, we can still...
End it already. You know, just between us, I was gonna let you live. But now...
You're going to miss me.
No, I won't.
For Lily and Faith.
Yes, another one of us to erase from the books.
Skin slip on me'd rip his head off. I suppose that would have been ironic justice, having him lose his head too, but I don't know. I thought the witching well was a better punishment because he'll be falling forever. It is a punishment that will continue forever. And he'll never escape either, so that's good too. Imprisoning him would have been a bad idea.
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
This fucking line.
Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
He's just like, so what? I'm a pig.
Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
Carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit! You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you? It's just a farm. You don't have to be so dramatic about it. Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance, but Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway. I told her I had the money, but she didn't want to hear it.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby, I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Aww. Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... If you could bring it to her, she was nice. So...
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best.
Aww.
It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
Aww.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like
it's
at the
so
farm?
So sweet.
I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
We have to go. I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
Don't worry. You'll be a lot safer there. There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby, so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundi seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
Stock thing. Sure. That's great.
Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby! Where's your friend, Colin? Where's a fucking pig?
How should I know?
He gets to stay. Fuck you.
Saying goodbye?
Hi.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh, yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
Need to let that go.
How are you gonna move on if you...
Bigby, I know you're trying to help, but this is just something I need to do on my own. Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. I'm not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they go just to silence someone who had physical evidence? I had to.
Narissa, just tell me what happened.
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
You were just trying to protect them.
Yeah. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God. I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this, not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
So you think that makes it okay to lie?
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith. I tried to warn Lily. But she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
Oh.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her. Just hoping that maybe if I couldn't save them, could at least save the rest of us.
So that piece of fabric I found near there, that was you?
Yeah, I cut my leg trying to get over the fence.
So you started all this?
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
It's not true.
It is. You've just never seen it before. But now you have. You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other, and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
I go out there, and I do my job. I put my life on the line. I get shot at. I do what has to be done for them. But at the end of the day, I'm still the bad guy.
I know. But they'll come around. You'll see. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You knew when to show mercy, and you brought justice to this town. Finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good here.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you. You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too. Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.
I'll see you around, Wolf.
Well, damn. That was freaking awesome. What did you do to Georgie? You and 68.6% of players killed Georgie. Did you give the Crooked Man a trial? You and 89.6% of players brought the Crooked Man back alive. I bet this episode would have been a lot shorter if you'd killed him at the warehouse there. How did you punish the Crooked Man? Oh, wow. You and 38.6% of players threw the Crooked Man down the witching well. So, that's... I don't know if that's a minority or if the others were evenly split as well, but, wow. Did you accept TJ's gift for Snow? You and 98.5% of players decided to accept TJ's gift for Snow. Well, what's up with that 1.5% of heartless bastards? Holy shit. What were your last words to Nerissa? You and 54.8% of players said, I hope I've done some good here. Well, there you go. And thus endeth the chronicle. Oh, special stats. Oh, here we go. Beast. You lied to him about seeing Beauty outside the apartment. Beauty, you promised her you wouldn't tell Beast that you saw her outside the apartment. Bluebeard, you fought him after the interrogation. Butcher, you beat him up during the interrogation. You offered him protection at the business office. Colin, you gave him a drink when he asked for one in your apartment. And you helped him to avoid the farm. Crooked Man, deceased. You took him back to the witching well. And then you tossed him down the witching well. Faith, you gave her money after the fight with the woodsman. Georgie, you smashed up his place. You took money from Georgie's safe. Well, it was my money. Gren, you ripped his arm off at the Trip Trap Bar, and you drank with Gren after Lily's funeral. Excuse me. Nerissa, you tried to take her ribbon off in Bigby's office. That would have been a very short story, too, if that had succeeded. Snow, you brought her with you along to the Trip Trap. You showed her Crane's photograph of her, and you promised to bring the Crooked Man back alive. Tiny Tim, you chose to wait for him. Good old Tiny Tim. TJ, you accepted his beetle and promised to give it to Snow. Toad, you stood up for him when Snow wanted to send him to the farm. And you gave him money. And he got sent to the farm anyway. So, poor Mr. Toad. Skinslip says, the farm is terrible. Awful. Nobody wants to be in a Fable concentration camp. And regarding his wanting me to rip off Crooked Man's head, I was saying, well, now he'll be falling forever. It says, well, if you ripped off his head, he'll be falling forever in agonizing pain. Agonizing pain! Forever! Actually, I don't think he would have been. I think he just would have been dead. He would have been dead, falling, a corpse, falling forever. No pain happening there, just dead. But, And finally he says, want more game. Yes, but alas, it looks like that's it. I don't know if they're going to be doing more in the World of Fables or not. I'm guessing not, because even though this one is incredibly well received and very beloved by fans, there's been no word of a follow-up. They seem to be busy with a lot of other franchises. Well, more Walking Dead, of course. I don't know if they're going to do a season 2 of Game of Thrones. That's when I got to finish, actually. I still got to finish episode 6 of that. And then, yeah. Skislip says, congrats on reading messages wrong. I read them right, just sideways. I gave my interpretation of them. That was really good. I can definitely see why people who've been... Oh, and thanks to me. You're welcome. Oh, somebody's pet died during the making of the game. That sucks. Well, in a forthcoming comic book update, I think you'll be seeing some Fables. Oh, there you go. Continue the story. Pick up a graphic novel today. There you go. Very nice. Yeah, I definitely want to read the comic now. The trade paperbacks are actually fairly inexpensive, so I might pick up a couple first time. Well, that was excellent. Let's just take a quick peek at the extras here. The Book of Fables, which we've been unlocking stuff like mad throughout the game. Holy moly! Okay, that's a lot of... all the characters in the entire game. So just a couple that we weren't able to... it's locked. Oh, there we are. Big B Wolf. The renowned Big Bad Wolf. He's known for tormenting pigs and girls in red hoods. He's trying to put those dark days behind him. Big B now acts as Fabletown's sheriff and remains in human form, mostly. However, due to his rough past, the citizens of Fabletown are slow to trust him. Big B is determined to show that he's truly changed, but some instincts are just too hard to control. Snow White. Snow White may seem cold, but this stems from her life of mistreatment and abuse back in the homelands. After escaping assault and imprisonment, not to mention an attempt on her life, she married Prince Charming. It wasn't long before Snow discovered that Charming cheated on her with her estranged sister, Rose Red, and she divorced him. Wow, what a dick. After the exodus, Snow focused her attention on setting up a safe haven for fables in the new world. She now serves as assistant to the deputy mayor of Fabletown. Well, not anymore. The Woodsman. The Woodsman is one of the few men who went toe-to-toe with Bigby in his Black Forest days and lived to tell the tale. In an attempt to save Little Red Riding Hood, he split the Great Wolf's belly open with his axe, filled him full of rocks, and threw the beast into a river. To his dismay, his popularity has faded. Even his name is forgotten, and he is only known as the Woodsman. Faith. Let's take a quick skim here. Uh-huh. And Beast. And what? And Mr. Toad. Colin, Couch Surfer. Colin is better known as one of the Three Little Pigs. Back in the homelands, they were harassed by the Big Bad Wolf, who blew down Colin's house of straw. Ah, that's which one he was. Okay. I think he mentioned that in the first episode. After the exodus, Colin and the other fables who couldn't pass for human were sent to live at the farm in upstate New York. Unable to stand such a boring life, Colin constantly makes trips down to Fabletown to bother Bigby. He's always caught and sent back to the farm, but he doesn't let that stop him. Ichabod Crane. Oh, let's see if this tells us how he survived. Hailing from the haunted town of Sleepy Hollow, Ichabod Crane has been deputy mayor of Fabletown for nearly 115 years. Crane is a bundle of nerves and takes his job very seriously, though that doesn't mean he always does it well. As one of Fabletown's elite, Crane is often blind to the troubles of the less well-off citizens. Overall, Crane is an authoritarian, He's authoritarian, cowardly, and always hiding something. Well, that didn't tell us anything. Okay. Bufkin! I love Bufkin. He's one of the flying monkeys from Oz, of course. Bufkin is the talking winged monkey from the Land of Oz. Now, as Fabletown's librarian, he spends his time reading and stealing the deputy mayor's booze. He's prone to mischief, so when something goes wrong, he assumes he'll receive the lion's share of the blame. He's helpful when he wants to be, but most of the time he'd rather be drinking. Someone would have fired him a long time ago, but he's the only one who can make sense of the filing system. Fabletown! Oh, okay, yeah, hold on a second, stuff. So, Fabletown is a community located on Bullfinch Street in Manhattan's Upper West Side. There you go, if you're in Manhattan, you can go and visit it. To regular people, or Mundys, it appears to be an ordinary New York neighborhood, but it is really the home of fables from many worlds. And within the business office at the Woodlands lies a massive cavern, a vast library, and hundreds of magical items of immense power. All non-human fables live upstate on the farm, an extension of Fabletown. The farm! Fabletown Annex. Yeah, we didn't really get to see the farm in this, it was just kind of mentioned. The farm is home to fables who cannot pass as human. Giants, goblins, animals, etc. It is located in upstate New York, far enough away from the Mundys to avoid detection. Some of its residents resent their confinement to the farm despite its size and comforts. To them, the farm is a prison. They would be allowed to leave the farm if they could purchase a glamour, but many don't have the money for something so expensive, though some, like Colin, sneak out into the city anyway. Mundys, just non-fables. Yeah. Glamours, we know about glamours. Prince Lawrence, well, we didn't get to know him very well. The Tweedles. Jerks. Holly. I like Holly. Grendel. Oh, look, he still has his arm. Bluebeard. Wealthy scoundrel. Bluebeard managed to escape the homelands with his riches intact and continues to be one of the wealthiest fables in New York. The Fabletown government depends on his generous contributions, and he often uses this influence for his own benefit. As a former serial killer, yeah, if you've ever seen a movie, I saw a movie adaptation of the story of Bluebeard a while back. He, like, killed a bunch of his wives. He claims his days of decapitating his brides are over. Oh, well, there you go. But even if he was able to leave his violent ways in the homelands, that hasn't stopped him from making the occasional trip down Crooked Lane. Oh, interesting. Big B's Vengeance! Long ago in the homelands, Northman fell in love with a blazing white she-wolf. Taking canine form, he courted her and stayed by her side for 2 seasons. However, the wind by nature must change direction, and North's temperament carried him back to his wintry castle. The she-wolf was heartbroken, and soon after her lover fled, she gave birth to a litter of cubs, including the one that would become the big bad wolf of legend. Watching his mother die of sadness and unrequited love, young Bigby Wolf swore vengeance against the capricious North Wind. 7 times the beast journeyed to the great castle, but was no match for the elemental might of his father. Having failed to taste vengeance, he swore to think no more of his dead mother or loathsome father. Buried hatred, however, is seldom forgotten. Well, that's interesting. They didn't really touch on that much in the game. Bluebeard's Mercy. 13th floor. This is like a whole bunch of stuff here. Imagine the Witching Well. Witching Well is located in a chamber inside the Woodland Building, which is used to dispose of things meant never to be seen again. Dead fables are committed to its depths, as are the most unredeemable criminals. No one is entirely sure what lies at the bottom of the well, nor indeed if it has a bottom at all, but it is widely assumed to be the passageway to the final resting place. Jack Horner. And Lily. We never see Lily with her head attached. Yeah. Troll Cross. Georgie Porgy. Clever Hans. Oh, from... Yeah, okay. It does exactly... Okay. Well, there we go. Nerissa. Oh, right. She was the Little Mermaid. That's interesting. Goes by Nerissa now. Not Ariel. Nerissa. Troll Funeral Rites. Vivian. Dr. Swinehart. Sorry, Vivian. His past is unknown. Yeah, Dr. Swinehart, Flycatcher. Oh, he was the Frog Prince. Okay, I didn't realize that. That's cool. Swinehart, Army Surgeon, Trip Chat Bar, Auntie Greenleaf, the White Deer. Well, Glamour Tube, Ring of Dispel, Bloody Mary, the Urban Legend. See, there you go. That's cool. Silver Bullets, Acting Deputy Snow White, Donkey Skin Coat, The Jersey Devil. Yeah, I like how they did him. He was actually really cool. Woodsman's Axe, Johan, Bluebeard's Money. There's a lot of information in here. Like, there's just tons and tons of stuff. Crooked Man, Tiny Tim. Life on the farm. With its idyllic location and managed community, the farm would seem to be a welcome alternative to eking out an existence in Fabletown. But those who have lived there see it very differently. They see it for what it is, a prison. A place where you are free to be who you are and do whatever you please, except leave. It doesn't help that while fables who appear human do not have to worry about being sent to the farm, they always seem to fill the leadership roles there. Vivian, the girl with the ribbon. Yes. Pudding and Pie, the big bad, oh, Big B's true form, there we go. That was pretty awesome when he took on Bloody Mary's true form. Fabletown Justice, A New Order, Sheriff Big B, and that is it. Wow, that was there's a lot of stuff there. Quite a deep and rich lore to this. I'm very impressed, I have to say. Very impressed indeed. Must read all the comics. Alrighty, folks. Yeah, I figured. Skinslip says Bigby's origin is detailed in the comics. I'm assuming that a lot of that stuff we just read is, you know, except for characters that only appear in the game, of course. I'm assuming that a lot of that is fleshed out in detail over the course of the comics. But very cool. No more games tonight, Great Red Shark. It's like 20 after 4 in the morning. I gotta do some editing and then go to bed. So, I'll see you guys tomorrow night for more gaming fun. Until then, I must bid you adieu. So until next time, thanks for watching, and sayonara.